A while back, Lisa and I went to the movies and we were watching these previews. And we were like, man, we've got to see that movie. Those previews are incredible. There were just four quick scenes and it was just like action and romance. Whoa, we get to see that. Well, the movie came out, we saw it, it was horrible. We're like, oh, the previews, just about that much. Man, they were awesome, but the movie was painful to watch. Oh. That's what Satan does with sex. That's what he does with adultery. That's what he does with premarital sex. He shows us just a few previews. Oh, this is incredible. Clandestine meetings, out-of-town business trips where you meet with the person and no one knows about it. Hotel rooms and this and that and the highs of ecstasy and all that. But that's just a little bit because the movie, friends, is painful. And some of you know exactly what I'm talking about. You know the pain. You know the agony of it. Sexual sin is always before us because sexual sin is unique. It's multifaceted and multidimensional. It's not just a physical thing. It's a spiritual thing, an emotional thing, a psychological thing. So we think we're getting one thing when we commit adultery, when we get involved in sexual sin. Ultimately, we get the opposite of what we think we're getting. That's what's so sinister about it. Sometimes when we're prideful and a little bored, we can be emotionally low. We're in a rut and we want a quick fix. And when we're vulnerable, when we're walking on the edge and the ledge of compromise, we're more susceptible to overspending, overeating, and oversexing. We face the consequences of sin. Some of the time, no. All of the time.